So we are going to discuss about the anatomy of upper respiratory tract. But before starting this topic, we have to know about what is upper respiratory tract. Upper respiratory tract organ provide a route for air to move between outside atmosphere and the lungs. They also clean humidity and warm the incoming air. However, no gas exchange occur in this organ because this is only the pathway. So it consists of nasal cavity, oral cavity, pharynx, larynx and trachea. Here we have a diagram like in which we show that nasal cavity, oral cavity, pharynx, larynx and trachea. And rest of the parts like a soft palate, hard palate, nostril, tongue are the further division of the nasal cavity and oral cavity. So let's discuss nose. Nose is a pyramidal shape. It consists of the nasal root, apex, dorsum of nose, some bones and cartilages. So nasal root is located superior, which is continue with our forehead, and apex of the nose ends inferiorly like a rounded tip. Spanning between the root and apex is the dorsum of the nose. Located immediately, if we look at it immediately below the inferior to the apex, we see a nares, a piriform opening which is distributed in vestibule into the nasal cavity. These nares are bounded medially through the nasal septum. Nasal septum is division between the right and left airway, and laterally through the cartilages like ala nasi. So we have a diagram like we have root, ala apex, dorsum nasi. Skeleton of external nose basically consists of the bone and cartilaginous. Bony component which is located superiorly and consists of the nasal bone, maxilla bone and frontal bone. Cartilaginous component located inferiorly and consists of the cartilages like two alar cartilages, septal cartilages and also many smaller alar cartilages. So as you show in this picture, like we have a nasal bone in a yellow color, maxilla in a orangish color, septal in a purplish color, lateral in a greenish color, major alar cartilages in a purplish color, minor alar cartilage in a reddish color. So paranasal sinuses. What is first of all sinus? Sinus is like cavities or hollow spaces between the skull and the facial bones. So paranasal sinuses are air-filled extension of the nasal cavities. Basically, we have four paranasal sinuses, which is named according to the bone in which they are located. Like a maxillary sinus, which is located in the maxillary bone, frontal sinus, which is located in the frontal bone, sphenoid and ethmoid. What is its function? Its function to lightening the weight of the head, supporting the immune defense of the nasal cavity like through the mucus or humidifying air or cleaning, humidifying inspired air, increasing resonance of the voice, which is very essential function of the nasal cavity. So first of all, we discuss about the frontal sinus. Frontal sinus located within the frontal bone of the skull. It is most superior and in the triangular shape. Its sensation is supplied through the supraorbital nerve, which is a branch of ophthalmic nerve, and arterial supplies via the anterior ethmoidal artery like a branch of internal carotids. Sphenoid sinuses, as according to the name, it is located into the sphenoid bone. They open into the nasal cavity in an area superior posterior to the superior concus, known as sphenoethmoidal recess. Basically, sphenoethmoidal recess is a small space in the nasal cavity into which the sphenoidal sinus and posterior ethmoid sinuses are open. It lies posterior and superior to the superior concus. They receive blood supply from the pharyngeal branches of maxillary arteries. Ethmoidal sinuses. Ethmoidal sinuses consist of located in the ethmoidal bone, consists of three parts: anterior, middle and posterior. Anteriorly, it opened into the hiatus semilunaris. Hiatus semilunaris is a crescent shaped groove in the lateral wall of the nasal cavity just inferior to the ethmoidal bulla. It is the location of the opening for the frontal sinus, maxillary sinus and anterior ethmoidal sinus. Middle open into the lateral wall of middle meatus, and posterior, basically the word meatus means the opening. So posterior opening into the lateral wall of the superior mitis. Anterior and posterior ethmoidal arteries are responsible for all arterial supply. Maxillary sinus are the largest of the sinus, as according to the name, it is located in the maxillary region. They are located laterally and slightly inferior to the nasal cavity. They drain into the nasal. Basically, its main function is to provide a potential pathway for spread of infection, fluid draining from the frontal sinus that can enter the maxillary sinus. As you see in this diagram, we have green in a frontal sinus, purplish in a ethmoidal sinus, red is the saphenoid sinus, and fourth one is the maxillary sinus. Like in a blue region is a maxillary sinus, red region is a saphenoid sinus, purplish region is the ethmoid sinus, and greenish region is the frontal sinus.